Today we will see the line synchronized UJT triggering circuit for the SCR. Now what is the meaning of line synchronized UJT triggering circuit? So basically the circuit is built up along the UJT. So UJT is used as an oscillator for generation of the pulses that will be applied to the gate of the SCR. But what is the meaning of line synchronization UJT triggering circuit? So line is basically this input voltage which we have applied over here, and here these both the voltages are synchronized to each other. Now why we require synchronization? Because the moment at which you want to apply the firing pulse to the gate of the SCR should start conducting at that particular point only. So that's why we need to synchronize the circuit. Now which is the point of synchronization? The point of synchronization is nothing but the zero crossing. So whenever my input voltage crosses zero, that point is called as the zero crossing. So this zero crossing is the point of synchronization. Then it is providing the isolation between the high power circuit and the low power circuit. Means what? If anything goes wrong in the high power circuit, that will not damage your low power circuit. So that's why there is an isolation between these two states, power circuit and the triggering circuit. So let us see how this triggering circuit works. Now in this triggering circuit we have a bridge rectifier. This bridge rectifier will convert the input AC voltage into the DC voltage. By conducting these devices, diode D1 and D2 will conduct in positive half cycle, and diode D3 and D4 will conduct in the negative half cycle, and will get such type of rectified output over here. Now here we have not connected deliberately the capacitor to filter out the DC, because we want this pulsating DC to be appear over here. Now the DC voltage, this DC voltage will appear at this point. Now for this DC voltage, the Zener diode is going to be conduct. Now the Zener diode I have connected over here is of 12 volt. Means the moment my input voltage, this voltage will cross the 12 volt, my Zener diode will start conducting and it will clip the voltage. Means whatever the voltage coming across the Zener diode, that will remain constant for the entire half cycle. So this is the half cycle for which my output or Zener voltage will remain constant. Okay, so this is the voltage. Now after this point, what will happen again for next half cycle? Again my Zener diode will comes into the conduction at 12 volt and it will remain constant across the 12 volt. It is as simple as you are studying the Zener diode as a regulator. So in Zener diode regulator, the Zener diode will conduct only when it achieves the Zener voltage. So whenever the Zener voltage is achieved, what happened? The Zener diode starts conducting. And because of that, the VZ of 12 volt, this 12 volt will appear at this point. Now you can eliminate this circuit and directly connect the plus 12 volt over here. But in that case, the synchronization is not possible. Means to achieve the synchronizations deliberately, I have built up this circuit over here along with the UJT triggering circuit. This is basically the triggering circuit. UJT triggering circuit will generate the firing pulses. But for generating the firing pulses, we require the DC voltage to be generated. And that DC voltage should be synchronized with the power circuit. So power circuit input voltage and this voltage should be synchronized. Means they are taking from the same tap. So there is a tapping between this voltage and this voltage. Okay. Now once you get the 12 volt at this point, what will happen? For this 12 volt, the capacitor will charge from this path depending upon the position of the pot. So it depends upon the pot position how much current will flow through the capacitor. So as this voltage is applied over here, what will happen? The upper plate of the capacitor will become positive and lower plate become negative, and the potential on the capacitor keeps on increasing and increasing and increasing. When the potential on the capacitor goes on increasing, what happens? This emitter voltage VE, this emitter voltage is also increased because of this positive voltage. So what will happen? the at a particular voltage, emitter voltage, this UJT will starts conducting. And when the UJT starts conducting, what will happen? The capacitor gets a path to discharge, because this is a switch. And when this switch is closed, what will happen? This capacitor will start discharging through it. And when it will discharge, this is the pulse transformer which is connected over here. So this pulse transformer primary winding gets the current, which is because of the conduction of the UJT. And the UJT current will lead the primary voltage in the pulse transformer. And accordingly, there will be a generation of the secondary pulse. Now, since it is a pulse transformer, the output of the pulse transformer is in the form of pulse. So these pulses will be coming out from this pulse transformer secondary winding, which is applied at the gate of the thyristor. And this negative point is connected to this. So what will happen? This pulse will be applied to this. Now see here, in this case, I have connected the bulb. The bulb is a resistive load. So that's why this sharp pulses is enough to trigger the SCR. But if you have a motor load over here, so what will have our inductive load, these sharp pulses will not work. You will have to use the pulse stretcher circuit. Now what is mean by pulse stretcher circuit? Pulse stretcher circuit is a simple circuit which you will have to increase the duration of the pulse. So in short, you will have to apply the square wave at the gate of the SCR to turn on that SCR, because for inductive load we know that. So the current inductor opposes the sudden flow of change in current. So that, because of that, what will happen? The SCR will not get sufficient time to latch. So because of that, we'll have to increase the duration of time for which the pulse should appear on the gate to cathode junction of the SCR. And that, because of that, what will happen? The SCR will get sufficient time to latch. And once it will latch, what will happen? The current will get circulated through the SCR. Now here I am using the SCR, which is TYN612. Now what is the meaning of TYN612? TYN612 is nothing but it is the SCR, that is of thyristor family, which is having the 600 volt at 12 ampere of current rating. So the maximum voltage and current rating will be given here, that is 612, and that is the rating of the SCR.